following integrals.
Take it to one side, make it the subject of the formula, and that's all you can do.
So things are not pretty straightforward as it appears from the formula itself. There can be lot of other intricacies involved. Try the second one now. This may be a probable question in school. I've seen this in some UP and some exams. Please be thorough with the basic formula at least, because again, if you don't know the formula for integration of secx, cosecx and all those things, it will be a big problem for you. Because today itself you are going to learn few more other formulas. So it's, you keep on piling up. Is that the second one? For second one, take sine inverse x as theta. So x is sine theta. So dx will be cos theta d theta. Okay. Now replace it back, you will get theta square. And dx will be cos theta d theta. Okay. Now, this is your algebraic function. This is your trigonometric function. Right? Layard rule. Now you'll ask why theta is an algebraic function. See, don't go by the symbol. Yeah. It's just think like it's the square of the variable. Just like x square. Okay. So in the same formula, wherever there is an x, start treating that x as theta. Okay. Yeah, so apply integration by parts. So u times integration of cos theta is sin theta minus du by d theta is theta square derivative with respect to theta. So 2 theta into again sin theta d theta. Okay, 2 you can pull it out. Now this is again a problem for me. So I have to again apply IVP here. So here again you will apply IVP, treating this as U, treating this as V. Other things you copy as such without any change in them. So it is U. What is the integral of sine theta? Minus cos theta. Minus theta integration is 1 with respect to theta. And minus cos theta will make it this. Correct? Vishal, clear? So it becomes theta square sine theta. By the way, can I make a change here itself? No, sir. So cos theta integration is sine theta. Open the brackets. You will get theta square sine theta plus 2 theta sine theta. Sorry, 2 theta cos theta. Minus 2 sin theta plus theta. Now the problem with this substitution is you cannot leave your answer in theta. You have to replace it back in terms of x. Correct? And that may take a bit of your time. But however, the entire process becomes pretty streamlined. Now theta here is sin inverse x. So can I say it is x sin inverse x whole square? 2 theta is sine inverse x and cos theta is under root 1 minus x square. Because if sine theta is x, cos theta is under root 1 minus x square. Okay. Minus 2 sine theta means minus 2x plus c. This is going to be your final answer. Again, the learning from this problem is you may have to apply integration by parts.
Why?
Why is the sine depending on the problem?
What is the sine?
Sine
inverse
x.
Integration
by parts.
One second, both of them are difficult to take. Yeah. Yeah. Take it as one thing. Defeating the basic purpose that one of them should be an easy one to integrate, another one should be a difficult one to integrate. The other way you can take one. The other approach may be that. But I think this approach is the most suitable one. You never integrate sine term.
No.
Integrate one.
Yeah.
So differentiation you can do.
No,
second. Why is it difficult? X by under root 1 minus x square is easy to integrate.
Yeah.
There will be an x generated, no? And there will be under root of 1 minus x square generated. That is easy to integrate. So that will be u, x by under root 1 minus x square will be v.
So we end up getting the same.
You end up getting the same.
No, not the answer only. In some point of time, you will get the same answer. Because sine is exactly.
No. Same thing, how? You're losing your power.
I mean, instead of.
The power is losing out continuously. You'll never get the same thing back. These are all school level problems. Then you start taking up the JEE ones after this. Okay, for the third one.
Sir.
You want to try? For the third one, let's first do a quick analysis of this term. Okay. Do you remember that we had done a similar formula in inverse trigonometry? That cot inverse of x is tan inverse of 1 by x provided x is positive. Now, you see this quadratic expression. Now, if you see this quadratic expression carefully, you will realize that its discriminant is negative. Correct? And coefficient of x square is positive. So any quadratic expression whose discriminant is negative and the coefficient of the highest power is positive, that means the term will always be greater than 0. So I can clearly say that this can be written as tan inverse 1 by 1 minus x plus x. And now tan inverse 1 by 1 minus x plus x square could be written as tan inverse x minus 1 by 1 plus x into x minus 1. Yes or no?
Yes sir.
Which is nothing but tan inverse x minus tan inverse x minus 1. Okay. So instead of integrating this fellow, with respect to x, you can choose to integrate this with respect to x. Yes or no? Which is easy to do. We already have seen the integration of tan inverse x. Can somebody tell me what is the integration of tan inverse x?
X tan inverse x
minus half ln mod 1 plus x. See, again, when you remember this, you saved how many minutes? 2 minutes to do it. Okay, so that is the advantage. And I'm not asking you to sit and memorize tan inverse x in this sample. No, through practice, you should be knowing it. Okay. So once you know this result, writing this result becomes a very easy task. It just becomes x tan inverse x minus half ln 1 plus x square minus. Now the same thing you have to repeat for this, just replacing x with x minus 1. So the answer would be x minus 1 times tan inverse x minus 1 minus half ln mod 1 plus x minus 1 the whole square. You may want to open the bracket and, you know, cancel out some terms and take things common. That can be done. Alifi, done? Fourth one done? Okay, so let's discuss this. Now, I take the same approach as what Kubrick did. He converted this to root x by under root of root a square plus root a square, right?
Yeah.
So basically this is nothing but tan inverse of
root x
by root a. This is root x. Let's call it as theta. Okay. So basically you are integrating tan inverse of root x by a dx, and I am calling it as theta. That means x is a tan square theta. Correct? X is a tan square theta. That means dx is equal to a 2 tan theta into secant square theta d theta. Yes or no?
Yeah.
So replacing it back here, it will become theta, 2a you can take out. So tan theta sec square theta d theta. Okay. Now by the virtue of the fact that tan theta is linked to sec square theta, can I say this term would be pretty easy to integrate?
Yeah, the entire term, if you
mind. Yes, so I take this entire term to be v and theta to be u. Why tan theta into sec square theta would be easy to integrate? Because tan theta is already present with its derivative. Correct? So integrating tan theta sec square theta would be a much easier task. In fact, we should know the result. So tan theta sec square theta, if you are integrating, take tan theta as t, so it becomes dt. Correct? So t dt, that's t square by 2, which is tan square theta by 2. Correct? No?
Yeah.
Now applying integration by parts here, so u times integration of this, which does not derive, tan square theta by 2 minus derivative of u, that is derivative of theta with respect to theta, which is 1. Integration of tan theta sec square theta is again tan square theta by 2. Correct?
Yeah.
Now it becomes pretty easy. Tan square I can write it as secant square theta minus 1. Any doubts so far? Sharanya, Vishali, Vishak. So far, so good. I substituted here. This is my theta and dx is my this entire. So 2a I pulled it out. So now this thing I took this part as v because it is easy to integrate, as I shown here, it is easy to integrate. And theta is a difficult one to integrate. It's not the difficult one, it's actually I tell you. This is a theta is also easy to integrate. Why are you taking theta as u? It's not about the difficulty level. If you integrate theta, it will continue growing in power. I want it to vanish. I don't want it to grow in power. Correct?
Yeah.
That's why we take the algebraic function as u. Yeah, so can we finally complete it? Oh, by the way, 2a is waiting outside. So your answer will be 2a times theta by 2 tan square theta minus half. What is the integration of secant square? Tan theta minus theta plus c. If you multiply the factor of 2a, you get a theta tan square theta minus a tan theta minus theta plus c. Correct? Now, substituting theta back. So A, what is theta? Theta is tan inverse root x by A. Tan square theta will be x by A. Again, tan theta would be root x by A. And theta will be tan inverse root x by A. Make sense?
Yeah.
You may want to cancel out this a, you can do that.